Hola. I started working in advertising like 30 years ago. And there is something that was always very clear for me. In 99% of the cases, ideas don't come easy.
Along with summer comes every family's worst nightmare. Dads in briefs.
I worked for many years at Saatchi, following the brother's heritage, Paul Arden's storytelling, Bob Eshwood's vision. I was spending time with big names like Tony Granger, David Droga, Jerry Graff, or Fabio Fernandez. I understood that each of them, or the great guys working with me in Buenos Aires, approached ideas through different creative stimuli. For sure, there is no manual for creativity. But seeing how my colleagues work in the search of ideas, I think it helps to classify all the stimuli that could give us weapons to face the blank page. We all have a unique universe within ourselves. The ones that consider themselves the most creative in the world, or even those who consider they were not born with this gift. Is creativity a gift? Is something exclusive to geniuses like Picasso, Leonardo da Vinci, Steve Jobs, or in our industry, David Droga? Or maybe, couldn't we all be Walt Disney without being aware of it? Can creativity be found? Do we know how to search within ourselves? Maybe the true talent is realizing when ideas are in front of our noses. Let's start with personal experiences. It is important to discover that even though we have an extreme life, or an average life, or even a boring life, there are a lot of things happening inside ourselves. Our lives are incredible sources of inspiration. I am an average tennis player, a chocolate addict. I am the father of an only one daughter, a huge fan of Asterix and Tintin. Pixar is my favorite company. I love to live in the highest floor of a building, but elevators scare me. I'm obsessed with Nespresso capsules aligned by colors. I'm the younger brother who hated to inherit from my elder brother bags, pencils, rackets that hurt, sweaters, jeans. That personal experience was the answer to a perfect laundry brief.
Gray's a little brother, standing by the road to show you're in the highway, but finally for sure you're going home. Searching for the sunset, feeling so alone, he said, hey you, what's that dude? He also said, I know the trip's so long. Crazy little funny brother, living through the day, tend to the dawn. Down behind a squirrel, waiting just to reach a breaking down. Searching for your brother, you're feeling so alone.
It's great to see creative teams coming from different types of families, different backgrounds, having completely different personal experiences. Twenty years ago, on a Monday, one of the best copywriters of the agency came with an incredible experience about his weekend.
Something you call love, but confess.
It was an unbelievable story. Was it true? I don't care, as it became a real piece of film.
Your best. These boots are made for walking, and that's just what they.
Quieto ahí, arriba la mano. Usted que mira. Sácate la ropa, la ropa te digo. La ropa. No, el pato no.
walking in the other shoes is a strong creative stimulus, and personally is the one that helped me more. I worked for some years in an agency that used to do focus group with all the ideas before going to the client. I became obsessed with that tool and with that possibility. And I discovered that in our job and in life, basically, we used to talk to the others as if we were talking to ourselves without understanding that the others are not us. When we understand what makes the others laugh or cry, which are the things that excited them or make them feel sad, then you have more chances to connect. And if you want to connect, you must know them. Have you seen how difficult it is to make the perfect Christmas gift or birthday present to somebody that is important for you? When you are in front of a blank page, try to think that your idea must be an unforgettable present.
First I was afraid, I was petrified. They flushed my head several times, exposing my behind. But then I spent so many nights working on my grand revenge. I'll be your boss, I'm gonna make you be my slave.
It's easier to connect with the kid I no longer am, as I understand his fears, his complex, or for example, I understand the value of independence when he's looking for his first mobile.
You'll be my pet. Yeah, yeah.
But what can I do to feel like the woman I will never be? What Mad Men was for me was what Sex and the City was for my ex-wife and for millions of women all over the world. The show inspired them through clear identification and empathy. Spying Sex and the City also inspired me to create this awarded product demo.
Mi amor, usted dice que el 90% de las mujeres alguna vez fingió. ¿Vos alguna vez fingiste?
No, te darías cuenta. Azúcar en otra suite.
Azúcar.
Una cucharadita o dos.
Dos.
Personal experiences, walking in the other shoes, knowledge, curiosity. Being curious is like rescuing that childlike look we tend to lose while we're growing up. There are lots of ideas that only appear thanks to a curious look. Many years ago, I was living in a house far away from downtown Buenos Aires in an open area with horses. However, I was coming to the city every single day to the office. One day I took my daughter, Manuela, she was 4 years old, I took her to the doctor. In the ride, she started telling me, "Look, daddy, there is a house and above a house and above a house and above a house." I didn't understand what she was telling me, and I realized that she was seeing an apartment building for the first time. We forget many times to think simple and obvious. We tend to complicate things.
Fairy tales can come true. It can happen to you.
Bobby, she would always remind us what Pablo Picasso was saying about the challenge of continue being creative while we're growing up.
To be narrow of mind, if you're young at heart.
It's easy to be creative when you are a little boy or a little girl. Real challenge is to keep that childlike look.
Don't you know that it's worth every treasure on earth to be young?
The thinking is childlike, not complicated. But maybe the complicated thing is daring to transform it into an idea. impossible to beat a team plenty of motivations. Maxi Itzhoff and Mariano Serkin were the great team in front of this idea. If we go to their personal experiences, Mariano's mother has a twin, and Maxi's wife also has a twin. But I'm completely sure that what helped them to approach this idea was the motivation to be Advertising Age International Agency of the Year.
Welcome. Which one seems like he has more friends? Which one has more imaginary friends? Which one gets invited to more parties? Which one gets invited to more bridge tournaments? Which one is the bad cop? Which of these bosses would give you a raise? Which one would fire you when you ask for a raise? Which one has a better sex life?
Motivation makes heroes. Motivations organize us. But what really makes us strong always in front of the blank page are las ganas. There's not a translation for ganas. Attitude, will, desire. I think that it's not enough to describe ganas with those words. You can have the experience of many, the flexibility of few, the creativity of very few, but it's what is going to really help you to walk tall are las ganas. When you are looking for the idea, when you finally have the idea and you want to make it happen, ganas is key. So, don't worry if you were not born with Pavarotti's voice, or you are not Messi, or you don't have Federer's backhand. You don't need that if you finally have the idea and you make it happen and you can build a movement around it. Personal experiences, walking in other shoes, knowledge, curiosity, questions, motivations, ganas, and luck. I was landing in Miami and I saw this baseball arena, and then this special tennis court came to my mind and my life changed forever. Muchas gracias.